So, if you have questions, please raise your hands if you see the project policies and second problem set.
Okay.
So, I hope you see that the deadline is very close for these activities. So, please don't waste your time and do it as early as you can. So today I will briefly talk about some examples of project topics to inspire your creativity and see the sources where you can find some relevant papers, ideas, and that can help you to create your own topic, your own project, and to speed up your preparation of the proposal. So the first one is the last year topics. So, well, I will share the link in the GitHub repository so you don't shoot photo or somehow copy this link. Here is four topics from this list. Sure you can find more and try to extend or implement something from them. I think that these topics can be divided into two groups. The first group is application of some matrix factorization, in particular SVT. And the second one is compression of some deep neural network stuff, some layers, maybe in matrix and tensors form or something else. So the first one here is some matrix factorization to extract important words. So the data here is some large corpus of the text. Then it's some preprocessed in vectors, one for the coordinates or something else. And then the authors here create some non-negative matrix factorization. And from this factorization, they try to extract what words of news is more important, and then try to cluster the news on the topic and create some prototype for the like Yandex novelty or something else, something similar stuff. So the next one is deep compression project, which is compress some layers on deep neural network and try to observe what level of accuracy will be reduced. This is quite popular and important topic. So now we have some projects in our group which try to make something similar. Questions maybe? Comments? No? Okay. And the third one is Laurent approximation of incomplete matrices, mostly about the optimization of the topic is to find the matrix that is close to the given matrix, but the given matrix is incomplete, so you know only some elements, and you add some constraints, usually on the rank of the target matrix, and try to solve this problem in different manners. So, for example, with the imaging optimization, with the alternating scheme, or something more advanced topic, advanced algorithms. You can find the presentation and the source code and try to compare with the algorithm presented here or try with different experimental setup or something different in the direction. And the fourth one is spooky authentication. It's one more application of the CD. This team collects some text for different authors and try to understand what author is more similar to the author that is known. So they compose the text, make some matrices, make them a CD, and for the new text, they perform something similar and then try to find the most similar known authors. You see that the moment this project mostly with the same structure. So here is some problem statement with the data, with the formal optimization or linear algebra problems, and this problem has specific applications. So you should create something that will have certain application, and this application is very important, so you please keep in mind this, that we don't expect that you will create some purely theoretical work, but it also can be part of some discussion maybe. That's all for last year project. Maybe some comments, questions.
Yeah. I would use this project as a pipeline for all.
Yes. But we expect that you will extend it in some direction.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So all the projects from this list you can use as a baseline. Okay, let's move to the second part. It's well, you can find here in this link the list of idea submissions. Let's check it. And here is the list of all paper, they're all anonymous. So this the search field, the way you can find where you can enter some topics, terms, or something relevant to the course, and find the paper that use or mention some terms that we used in our course. Then you can take this paper and try to implement it or compare with some baselines that you have your own but no mentioned in this paper. So for example, we can enter here simpler values and get this paper which just proposes some regularization of the deep neural network with projection of the layers to the one radius, one matrix with singular values equal to one. So they show how they can compute it efficiently. So they use FFT. This topic will come later in our course, and also with some circle of matrix that we will also cover later. But if now you can try to check what is the paper about and what methods do you. You have to know in advance before we will cover it in our topics. And then try to implement it and try to find some similar plots, maybe with better visualization. Okay, you can find here some related to CD maybe. Vectors, maybe. Yes, so. Well, try different terms here, see different vectors. Yes. So, when you select some papers, these papers have to be used to some methods and techniques of the course topics. So it's not enough if the paper will just mention some tensors or metrics, and it will not be okay if the main idea is some heuristic and not related to the course topics. Also, after you, well, when you choose the paper, you can ask in the answer, is it okay or not, and describe briefly what you want to do with this paper, and then we will answer you and tell how you can modify it and fix your idea to make it more appropriate for the project. So please don't hesitate to answer a question about what you want to do, because it's very important to ask before you make something to prevent the case when you make something not that we expect. And after that, you should write a proposal, and we will check a proposal, what you write and what you have to do. But in this case, you spend more time on not relevant activities, maybe. Is it okay?
What will happen if we submit a proposal and find that this proposal is not suitable?
Well, we will contact So just spend time not on the relevant media.
Yeah.
So it's not catastrophic, but not so good. Also here some more examples. The first one is the recent Facebook research paper and framework which called Rethinking Floating Point Philip Yerkin. You can try to just run the experiments from this paper, from this code, try to reproduce it and make some short tutorial on what the authors propose and how it can be relevant to what benefit it can achieve for the, to the deep learning field. The second one is here is a paper, and the main task here is to implement the algorithm that here is proposed and compare with the past information is queries and apply this to the recommender system. So if you would like to select this project, we will give the contact of our colleague who will mentor you for to implement and to compare with correct algorithms. Also, the last two applications, which can be very very insightful, is graph-related applications. A lot of problems that was that we are taking as a project in the last years related to the graph. One of the examples you will see in the problem set 3 and like vector clustering. So you can use some numerical linear algebra in graph-related applications and compute some graph matrix more efficiently or in some more appropriate manner and demonstrate that with large graphs which have sparse adjacency matrix, your method is better than the other used. So it's a very rich field for problems, for topics. And the last one is the different embeddings for structured data. You have already seen this example in problems 2, in Quantum, which is a reformulated matrix optimization problem. So there are more other topics, more other data that can be embedded in linear space, and from this embedding we can extract some useful information about this structured data which is not given when we use data as it is. So these two very big, very large area that can be used as project motivation. So is this okay? Questions? So please think about your projects and ask questions and some proposals when you will be ready. So that's all for today. Maybe Professor Vasilidis will talk something.
Yeah. The most successful LA project was the project that he applied certain tensor decomposition to compress convolutional layers of neural networks. And this paper was published in IKEA. The result of this project was later published in IKEA 2015, and it's not quite well said. The starting point was some guy who never knew any tensor decomposition or whatever, but then it turned out to be good research. So I suggest if you're going to do sort of research, but not really like linear programs and data science, think of something that could be a possible research paper afterwards. It's actually not so difficult. It's actually not so difficult, so please talk to your professors or other people trying to find ideas, because this could be, I don't know, but sometimes could be a good start for research. Why do you know technical things for the price of research? That's what I want to do. Now people will make that for whatever reason. Yes, because try to find something. So, everything that you need to do, try to use the design. So, the organization, so if you come up with a new